Hey YouTubers, well welcome to Deborah Star Trek Enterprise Refit Project Progress Video Update number 63. We have to be very quiet because it's about 4:30 in the morning. Daddy pulled an all-nighter, couldn't sleep again. And we have got a really big and strange show for you today. We're going to go over the progress done on the Enterprise and quite a bit on the secondary hull. We're almost done with the secondary hull, ready to move up to the pylons. And I know my friend Elliot Brown will be very excited to finally see his panel work all painted and detailed. That'll be cool. Let's see what else. Oh, we got a new bird. I went to a pet store just to buy some supplies for the fish tank. And there was this little, I believe it's a mother of pearl or pearl cockatiel that took a liking to me. It just kept following me in the cage. I'd walk around the store and he kept trying. And it's very sweet. It wasn't super expensive or anything. Although the cages and the food and the supplies, I guess, expensive. But anyways, brought him home. Found out it was a female. And it's kind of a mocha colored. So I called him Mookie. And it's his first night sleeping. He's in the other room right now. You'll get to meet him. Very sweet, adorable, big time baby. Only about 12 weeks old or something like that. Scared to death of everything. But every time I walk in the room, it's squawk, squawk. You know, I think we've bonded already. So you'll probably see him sitting on my shoulder eventually. I'm going to try and train him. Because Ruby is my wife's bird. And as you know, Mr. Lucky, well, he's nobody's bird because parakeets are either, you know, shoulder sitters or they don't want to touch you. And so let's see what we come up with Mookie. So we got three birds now. So that's the fun news. Let's see, what else? Oh, and we got the strange part of the show is a video from the professor. I don't know if you guys know, but, you know, this is a weird place. And the backyard is basically sort of a nether zone, a vortex. I don't know what to call it. You know, think of Doctor Who's TARDIS. You know, small on the outside, but all kinds of compartments and weird stuff. And sometimes when you go back there, you'll actually run into one in, like, Dare Smurf Village, you know, things like that. And the professor points the same thing out. He happened to go into some nether zone, and the houses are always empty there. You know, it's like time has gone past, but the structures are still there. Weird stuff, man. I told you, it's a strange show today. Hey, it's Monday. I can do anything. And he goes into this house, and there's sort of a green screen recording studio thing set up there. And, well, you know, you'll see, he did some wild stuff in there, and I hope nobody's offended. One part of it might be offensive. I don't mean to be. Just for fun. And then there's a very nice sort of thing about somebody that just passed recently. So you might enjoy it. Gotta warn you, though. Done live in a big room. The anechoics weren't great. There's a little clipping. You may have to play with the you know, your volume here and there, maybe your equalizer. And I invite anybody to go ahead and download that segment. And if you can process it, because, you know, Editor Smurf's got is like this big, and the 64 track is like that big. So he's running around the track trying to adjust things, and he didn't do a very good job because his little foot keeps hitting one of the switches and, you know, messing it all up. But I do invite anybody that's got really good sound processing skills, download the audio track or download the whole segment. See if you can make it better. The recording is not, the source material is not great to work with. But if anybody does that, I'll give them a prize. Never know what it can be. It can be money, it can be a toy, it can be almost anything. I always compensate people for their efforts. Ask anybody that's ever done anything for me. So I invite you to do that. You know, no problem. Download it and see if you can make it better. Some people are real whizzes at that. Editor Smurf, Sound Smurf, both of them just couldn't get it. But it is fun to watch. So I'll try to bear through it. You know, cringe when it gets clipping and too loud, but you know, it's kind of funny. So let's see, we're going to go over what's been done. I'm going to tell you about what I'm going to be doing this week. We are getting very close, guys. We're a few weeks away now. I'd say if I'm really jamming, 3-4 weeks, if I run into issues, 5-6 weeks, but not long. And then of course our historic road trip to Arizona to the client's new home. Should see this thing, man. It's like, I mean, really, what a house. Just incredible. That'll be a fun video. And we have plans. Steve is now working on the route to Arizona. We are going to stop at the Little Alien Inn in Roswell, somewhere I've always wanted to visit. UFO hotspot. Gonna do a video there. Who knows who might show up? Professor, Trek Nazi, whatever. Hopefully the cafe owners won't kill us, or we won't be abducted on the extraterrestrial highway. So Steve is planning quite a fun route. We're gonna take a van out there to deliver this thing, and then we're flying back. Because once we've deposited the Enterprise, we don't have that much to haul. Whatever equipment I bring, a little bit of audio, video equipment, and maybe a ghost hunting gadget or two, because where we are is pretty spooky place. I mean, there seems to be a lot of space around. Anyways, we'll cover that. But I can only bring as much as I can bring back. Or if we, you know, have some really hot spots where I do want to bring the ghost gear, I can always ship it back UPS. But that stuff's, you know, expensive and it is delicate. So we'll see. We'll see. But that's some fun stuff. So let's move on. All right. So here's a view of most of the areas I've worked on. Now, I will go to the rear part of the ship because the shuttle bay's been opened up. Mostly detailed except for the black stripe details. But opened again. Cleaned up. I've got those gray sections with the tractor beam lighting ready to go. And of course, when I start turning on all the lights, there'll be a little bit more tweaking because I'm sure there's some paint splotches here and I'm not seeing very tiny ones, albeit. All right, so let's take a look at this. Right now, what you're seeing is the entire bottom of the saucer and all the blue work. Basically, the whole bottom of the saucer is done. I just haven't mustard misted the phaser banks on the top and bottom. That's something I'm going to do towards the end. Blue striping. Photon torpedo bay, we'll get you a look at that. Sensor array here, I believe it's a planetary sensor. And all kinds of goodies. So we're going to give you a few different views. This is a striking view here. I've got a lamp going below, giving you a nice look at that Aztec-ing. And let me see here if I can do this in my usual professional way. Let's see. And there you go. There's some of those details. Focus, focus. And very pretty. Kind of love the Aztec. And notice all those door sections have also been done. Let's take a closer look at those if we can. There you go. Gotta love the way the Aztecs look. And see, it's got definitely that sheen, negative, positive thing going. And of course this. Now this isn't completely done and it needs a little touch-up work, but it's not bad. Four dish and then silver, like I said, I saved for last because those things rub off easily. And now we're heading towards those pylons. And as you can see, those are masked off and ready to get that blue. So now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna give you a forward view. Give you a look at the photon torpedo section. And we'll take a look at the shuttle bay too. Moving on. All right, here's the forward view. Getting a nice look at that underneath saucer. Now the photon torpedo bay has always been an interesting spot for me. It's actually a medium grade, at least in my opinion, and there's a lot of grid and detail work in there. So you can see, that's a nice standout little section. And as we pull back a little bit, the blue striping, planetary sensor, all those door sections. And of course the stripes. Now the stripes are as close to perfect as I can get them. Also remember the width of the hull, side edges of the hull, vary slightly by a few millimeter in here. This is a garage kit. And I'm not unhappy with it. Remember, this is a handmade thing, guys. It's not perfect. Anybody that says anybody's work is perfect is lying through their teeth. There's that photon again. Well, I can't wait to see some of this stuff light up. So now let's take a look at the rear view. And I'm sorry I haven't shown you any more hands-on stuff. Like I said, I'm working very, very hard on this to get her done. I have a couple side projects to do, one for a fellow in France. And he's been very, very patient, and I promised I'd do that in the week between the two projects. I usually take a week off after a big project. So I'm going to have to work on that. And it's a wizard's figure mounted up on Beast. If any of you are familiar with Bakshi's work, you'll know that that's a very, very cool model. And my friend Tim Nolan from Rat Daddy Studio made me a very nice one. And I'm going to do my version for this client. So let's move on. Okay, here's that rear view. Again, some of the blue striping work in the back. The impulse grills will be going on soon. They're black. The stripings are a little off back here. There's still a little touch up here and there, but overall, she's really starting to look good. Nothing's perfect till I say so. So here's that shuttle bay, and there's those gray tractor beam section. Now, those guys have quite a lot of little details. There's quite a lot of little grid work in there. Some of it's a little toned down silver, a little darker blue. It's kind of a little sections and little squares and things in there. That'll be added in. And then we're going to add the black details. Now, the black details, there's an actual little black tile here on both sides. And then there's a stripe with a break, two-stripe break right here on the bottom lip. So that's what I need to add here. And, of course, there's the phasers up here, which will also get that green and then mustard. And that'll pretty much do it, along with that sensor array in the front, deflector dish thing or sensor dish, whatever you prefer, will be finished off once I get the pylons and the engines going, because then it's up on the stand. And then we have to order that big display case. Yes, and this time I'm going to ship it to the right place, or else I'm going to get mad. They keep sending it to the office, not the studio. So there you go. Now, as the Enterprise drifts away, we will show that clip with the professor. As I said, your volume may want to be attenuated here and there during the performance, if you want to call it that. Professor doesn't have the greatest voice. Source material's not that great. Anybody wants to fix that up for me, you'll get a cookie at the very least. So I'll see you next time for update number 64, which should show pylons moving towards engines. And then we're going to wrap it up with all that lovely prismatic stuff. So I'll see y'all probably next week. Take care. Papa out.
It's all smurfing. I know you're hiding. I want those plans back. Nobody's supposed to know about that. Oh, what is this place? It's some kind of studio. Boy, I tell you, boys and girls, one of those stinking Smurfs has gotten something he should not have.
Yeah.
This is strange. This is one of those things that pop up in the backyard all the time. You know, Papa's backyard is sort of like a vortex. Things appear, things disappear. I don't know. It's like the bloody TARDIS in Doctor Who or something, you know? The yard looks so big, but then sometimes you go through these little gates and there's the Smurf Village. That's why nobody ever mows over the thing, because it's there, it's not there. And then there's these structures that pop up, these empty houses. It's very strange. I don't know what this one is. I cannot find that Smurf. Although this is very interesting. Perhaps I can have a little fun here.
Okay, boys and girls, let's try to have a little fun with this. Testing, is this thing on?
Yes.
I could be wrong. I could be right. Stop. I could be wrong. I could be right, I could be wrong, I could be right, I could be white, I could be black, I could be right, I could be wrong, I could be white, I could be black, your time has come, your second skin, I just never get to win, walk through the valley, and hope you don't run into some smurf or something, road rise with you, may the road rise with you. Wrong. I could be right. I could be wrong. I could be right.
Oh, that's good.
Is this thing wrong?
I could be wrong. I could be right. I could have been killed by Mossad last night. Wrong, I could be right. I'll definitely put up a fight. I could be wrong, I could be right. I don't know what to do anymore. The song is moving too bloody fast. Model cities in an ebony way. Oh, it reminds of you. Me like cries of you. Mwah! I'll smack it all into bed, bed! Anger is an energy. Anger is an energy. Anger is an energy. Anger is an energy. You know what? Let's try something else.
All right, he's a fellow. Just passed away. Was living the retired rock star life in Colorado. And I came this close to meeting him. If he had lived another year, perhaps it would have happened because I know someone who knows him and, you know, stuff like that. So I think we should give him a wonderful send-off, especially us older folks. Like, I'm 132, so I can relate to Gregorian, you know. But anyways, let's see what we can do.
Unchain my heart. Let me be. Cause you don't care. Please set me free.
Good stuff, man.
Unchain my heart. Unchain my heart, cause you don't love me no more. Every time I call you on the phone, some fella tells me that you're not at home. Unchain my heart, set you free. Unchain my heart. You don't care about me. You got me screwed up like a pillowcase. But you let my love go away. Oh, change my heart. Let me breathe. I'm under your spell. Like a man in a trance.
Unchain my heart.
Unchain my heart. Let me go my way. Unchain my heart.
Unchain my heart.
You worry me night and day. I live a life of misery. And you don't give a bag of beans for me. Unchain my heart. Oh, please. Set me free. All right. Chain my heart. Set me free. Cause you don't care about me. Oh, honey. Set me free.
No, I can't hold a candle to this man. Joe Cocker died recently, and many of us oldsters, it broke our heart. And I just can't go on. Goodbye, Joe. We love you, man. Not to find that stinking Smurf. Gonna miss that one.